Since its inception, Citizens for Justice and Peace has stood by people whose constitutional rights have been violated. People who sometimes face the might of a cynical system all alone. People who are often bogged down by these battles. Resilient people who have risen up to defend themselves and others around them with our help. Let us take a look at some of the ongoing battles that we are fighting.
अगर हम लोग फॉरनर होगा तो असम में जितने लोग आए सब फॉरनर होने पड़ेगा.
With a massive humanitarian crisis looming over Assam, with millions of Indian citizens threatened with a loss of citizenship, CJP has swung into action. We have a volunteer motivator in almost every district of Assam, and over 500 community volunteers are working round the clock, going door to door to help their own people tide over this crisis. With the help of a working office in Guwahati, we are able to guide and monitor this work. We have received more than 10,000 calls on our toll-free helpline number. Our work has impacted over 2 lakh families. We have helped the affected fill over 10 lakh NRC forms. With boots on the ground and our vast experience in dealing with crisis situations, we are one of the most active humanitarian organizations in Assam. A vicious and unequal battle is being waged on the Adivasis of Sonbhadra by the Uttar Pradesh administration, its police and local gundas.
Police wala mare goli chalaya aur wahi humko farzi mukadma laga diya.
All because the Adivasis are demanding their own land back under the Forest Rights Act 2006. Thousands of false cases have been filed and terrified activists are whisked away in the dead of the night. Through a prolonged legal challenge and a spirited public campaign, we managed to free Sukhdev, Sukalo and Kismati Agon.
हम लोग तो डर नहीं रहे, कोई चोरी थोड़ी किए हैं, किसी के जान नहीं मारे हैं, हम तो आंदोलन कर, हम अपने पेट के लिए लड़ रहे हैं.
We got the NHRC to demand a probe into police brutality in Sonbhadra. Through our team of lawyers in Uttar Pradesh, we are slowly but steadily challenging each and every false case filed against the Adivasis. Zakia Jafri case, Naroda Patia, Ode.
Silver society में जो मैंने अपनी आंखों से जो देखा है, वो मैं आप लोगों को कह नहीं सकती कि मैंने क्या देखा और क्या नहीं देखा. लड़कियों की इज्जत, लोगों का कत्लेआम, क्या वो सबको मार-मार के गिराना और कत्लेआम करना.
For the last decade and a half, CJP has been fighting relentlessly to get justice for the victims of Gujarat carnage, setting precedents and breaking new legal ground. For instance, the Zakia Jafri case is one of its kind, seeking substantive justice and also creating precedents in the collection of evidence. Perhaps this is why we find ourselves in the crosshairs of the powers that be. With a seemingly endless stream of cases, inquiries, and malicious propaganda. We understand that this is simply another effort to stop us from doing our work, but we have managed to continue while mounting a robust defense. In an atmosphere of ever-increasing polarization, hate speech is just another step in creating communal flare-ups. Using our experiences in tracking violence from Bombay riots of 1992 to Gujarat and other incidents, we have been able to launch India's first and only app to detect, report, and track hate spread anywhere in India. The app was immediately flooded with complaints against the reenactment of Gandhiji's assassination. Our idea of freedom of expression helped independent Gujarat MLA Jignesh Mewani and student activist Umar Khalid to file writ petitions to quash malafide FIRs against them. CJP is also engaged in bringing diverse voices together to speak against the rising tide of authoritarianism in India by organizing day-long conclaves like Netizens for Democracy and events like Fight the Mob, even becoming social media's talking point for the day. We thank the thousands of extraordinary Indians with whose help and participation we have come this far. But the fight is far from being over. In the coming months, we are looking to launch the Peace Map, a countrywide network of peace warriors who not only report hate, but also actively fight it. A campaign for minimum support price for forest produce is on the cards. We are also looking at scaling up our work in Assam to deal with the aftermath of the publication of the final NRC list. We want to mount legal challenges on behalf of each Indian fighting for citizenship, from foreigner tribunals to the Supreme Court. We also want to ensure that Assam's detention camps are constitutional and humane. And so, we intend to continue our fight for a better India for all Indians, to fight for our constitution, to fight for the last person on the streets, to fight for the last Indian. Join us and be a part of this journey.